हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 854 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज आर्टिफिशियल फर्टिलाइजर और इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से सिंथेटिक फर्टिलाइजर दैट इज कॉल्ड एनपीके, वेयर एन स्टैंड्स फॉर नाइट्रोजन, पी स्टैंड्स फॉर फास्फोरस एंड के स्टैंड्स फॉर पोटेशियम एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द नेचुरल सोर्स ऑफ fertilizer, that is organic fertilizer and inorganic fertilizer, and here I am going to discuss the synthetic or artificial source, means it is not from natural source. And this artificial source of fertilizer, they mainly contain nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, and on their bag it is written NPK fertilizer. And these are the nutrients of the plant, and nitrogen is there for the growth, vegetative growth, green photosynthesis, leaf growth. Phosphorus stands for the healthy root, good root, and potassium is for stem and for good shape and growth of seeds and fruits. And here NPK, when we are saying, it doesn't mean that the all are applicable at a time NPK. Sometime before applying this NPK, you should know first thing the pH of the soil, go for testing of the soil, and if any ingredient like nitrogen, phosphorus or potash in that soil is tested, and if it is high, for example nitrogen, so there is no need of putting nitrogen extra because it will be having more vegetative growth. And if in case the other ingredient is more, then it better not to put that because it will do harm rather than good. So that's why nowadays in on this bag they are writing like for example 2808. So if on bag it is written 2808, means 28% nitrogen and phosphorus 0 and potassium is 8%. And if in case on the bag of NPK it is written 10 10 and 10, it means here nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, they are all having in the same ratio, same quantity. So it is helping to farmers because you have to know some knowledge of the chemicals and your health of your soil, soil chemistry, otherwise it will not be beneficial. You know that some of the fertilizers, they are applicable only in acidic soil. If you apply alkaline soil, it will not be effective. And if in case any of these ingredients is in excess, it will not help in normal growth of the plant, production of the flower or fruit, and even the seed. So these factors have to be well understood. Only then we can apply the synthetic artificial fertilizer. So artificial fertilizer NPK, number one, artificial fertilizer NPK stands for nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. These three nutrients that compose complete fertilizer, and once these three are present, it is known as complete fertilizer or compost fertilizer. And if any one of these three is absent, then it is called incomplete fertilizer. And sometimes we need incomplete fertilizer because some of the nutrients may be in high percentage in soil. And these NPK corresponds respectively to the nitrogen content, phosphorus content and potassium content. Also apply percentage symbol, and I have already told you in the beginning that this nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium is given by number symbol, and that is sometimes 2808. It means that fertilizer NPK contains 28% nitrogen, 8% phosphorus, or means 0% phosphorus and 8% potassium. The other ratio, if it is written 10-10-10, it means that NPK fertilizer contains all these three nutrients, that is nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, in the same ratio, same quantity. That is the meaning of this numbering on the bag. I mean, the latest production, they are mentioning like that, because nowadays soil chemistry, agriculture is advanced, everything is tested. So after testing, they get the fertilizer, and sometimes if they don't need much phosphorus, then they will take 2808, or sometimes they may take 2880, means no potassium, like that. And if sometimes their soil is like that all three nutrients are necessary, then they can buy 10-10-10 numbering ratio of NPK fertilizer. Number two, importance of NPK fertilizer. What is the importance? The fertilizers, not all types of plants have the same nutrients. So all the plants, they don't have the same nutrients, and you can sometimes do more harm than good when applying NPK fertilizer without the knowledge of chemical. For example, applying fertilizer high in nitrogen percentage. So if in any soil plant, if the percentage of nitrogen already high, and if you are applying high percentage, that is your 2808 NPK, then you are pumping more nitrogen, means it will be having more vegetative growth, more leaf photosynthesis will be there, and only vegetative growth will be much. And if it is you require fruit or seed or root, that growth will not be there, so it will be a harm. Fertilizer high in nitrogen percentage will cause the some plant produce more vegetative growth, not the fruits. And you have to see these three factors. Number one, use compost instead of chemical fertilizer. Always go for complete compost fertilizer, which contains same percentage of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium as per it is required. B, get your soil tested, test its pH value, its alkalinity, neutral value or acidic condition. With that you will be able to know which type of fertilizer will be effective, because some fertilizers, they are not effective in acidic pH, soil, and some are not effective in alkaline soil. So that will help you, and also the percentage of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. That is C, apply slow release fertilizer, will not burn plant. If suppose you are applying any fertilizer which is not composed, means all ingredients are not equal, some one is very high, like urea only, nitrogen, then it can burn your crop, because it will be very fast in decomposition. So always the fertilizer which is slow in absorption in the soil and decomposition is far better than the one which is very fast. So here it is given the role of each nutrient. The first one is, that is nitrogen, N. It promotes leaf growth, means if nitrogen is more through stomata, gut cell, more senses will be there, and more vegetative growth will be there. And once it is in high percentage, this nitrogen, then the other growth will not be there, will be less. And B is phosphorus, P. It helps in the growth of roots. So if there is deficiency of phosphorus, the root underground will not develop very well. That's why in groundnut, root is very important because it is underground, fruiting is there. So phosphorus percentage should be checked in the soil. And if the phosphorus is less, so the production of groundnut is going to be affected. So that is very important. And so the phosphorus is essential nutrient for the plant, especially for healthy growth of root. C, potassium, K. It helps in stem development and seed growth. Seed growth means if suppose there is deficiency of potassium, then your seed will not be shining, will not look healthy, and it will be just like a dull color, and it indicates that there is deficiency of growth in the seed, and of course it is going to affect your productivity. So these three ingredients, nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, must be balanced, that is in the ratio of 10-10-10 means equal ratio. Then only you are going to get good crop. But if your soil testing says that out of these three, some one is more in percentage, then you can go to buy the incomplete fertilizer. Incomplete fertilizer means there are sometimes potassium may not be there or phosphorus may not be there. And complete fertilizer means where all three are present. So with this, I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.